topic is sampling distribution for sample mean X bar. So let's read the definition. The first definition says the condition and requirement. So the sampling distribution of the sample mean X bar is normal if the samples are drawn randomly, we call that SRS, and X has a normal distribution. And then definition two, for the central limit theorem, what it says is the sampling distribution of the sample mean is normal if these three conditions are met. SRS, the sample size of the sample size is bigger or equal than 30, and you want the standard the deviation of the population have to be finite. In other words, it's equal in number. And then once we know that the distribution of once we know the sampling distribution of the sample mean is normal, not only we know that, we know that also, let me do it here, we know that, see, the population distribution could be the population distribution for X, it could be normal, it doesn't have to be, it could be skewed. Doesn't matter, it could be skewed and it could be symmetric X. However, X bar, the distribution for X bar will always be normal as long as these two conditions, either condition one or the central limit theorem or condition two, is met. So not only that, we know that the mean, This is the distribution for X bar. So this point here will be the mean of the means. We know that's just equal to the population mean, and we know that. So here, this is what we mean with the population mean. This is mu. This number right here is the population mean. Let's assume standard deviation is sigma. So doesn't matter for either one, but here the mean will be somewhere in there. So the standard deviation for all the means will be equal to the population mean over square root of the sample size. Alright, so let's do this problem. Assume that the duration of human pregnancies can be described by a normal model. So we know it's normal. So we just need to use this condition. We know X is normal. That's what it says. So X, X is normal with mean equal to 266. So we know that mu is equal to 266, the population mean, and standard deviation is equal 16. So this is first question A, what percentage of pregnancy should last between 270 and 280 days? This is not even a sampling distribution problem yet. It's just a normal distribution problem. So the answer here, they're asking us for the probability of X to be between 270 and 280. So I'm just going to use the calculator. So this will be normal CDF. The lower limit is 270. The upper limit is 280. The mean is 266, the standard deviation is 16, and if you use your calculator, it's supposed to get 0.2105, which is 21.05%. For question B, at least how many days should the longest 25% of all pregnancy last? So what are they asking here? This is 25%. In other words, on the left, it would be 75%. So they're asking us to find at least how many days should the longest 20, yeah, in other words, they're asking us to find this x. Right? In other words, the 75th percentile, what we're looking for, at least how many days, at least how many days should the longest 25% of all pregnancy last? Remember, the calculator always work with the left area. So we're trying to find x. So using the calculator, so it's inv norm of, so we need to plug in 75%, which is 0.75, and then the mean is 266. The standard deviation is 16, and if you use your calculator, you're supposed to get 276.79 days. By the way, for this problem, we're looking for this area, and this is 270, and this is 280, right? And then we found that this is going to be 21.05%. All right, let's move on to question C. Question C says, suppose a certain obstetrician is currently providing prenatal care to 60 pregnant women. So we know that already N is equal to 60. And then X represent the mean length of their pregnancy. So X will be sample mean. According to the central limit theorem, what's the distribution of this sample mean X, X bar? Specify the model mean and the standard deviation. Well, the central limit, we don't even need the central limit here, but let's use it because we know all we need to check is that A, condition A, the samples are the SRS. So the 60 women represent is it a representative sample of all pregnant women? So it's not, it did not say that. So let's say this. So we're gonna assume. So we say assume that N equal 60, there's 60 pregnant women, or the women that the doctor is treating, represent, or is a representative sample of all, or let's just put is a representative sample of all pregnant women. Pregnant. In other words, the SRS is checked. Actually, that's all we need, but since they say central limit theorem, and let's just check the other two conditions. Second condition, we want to check that we did check A, B, N is bigger or equal than 30. So this is kind of like A. So that B, well, let's call it star. Second star will be N is equal 60, so it's bigger or equal than 30, so we're fine. And then 3 will be what? Yeah, we want to make sure that sigma is finite, and it is. Sigma is equal what? What did they say sigma is? 16 is a finite number. So specified. So this is check, this is check. Therefore, the central limit theorem says that the distribution of x bar, in other words, the sampling distribution of sample means, the distribution of x bar is normal. So we answer which part? Specifying the model. Now we need to talk about the mean. According to the theorem, the mean of x bars is just the population mean, which is equal to 266. What else? So we answer that. Now standard deviation of x bar by the central limit theorem, that's equal sigma, the population mean, divided by square root of the sample size. So that would be what, 16 divided by square root of 60, and that would be 2.07. So we answer all the questions. Now, for D, so we know that, so this is X bar. We know that this is going to be 266. And we know that the standard deviation will be 2.07. What's the probability that the mean, meaning X bar, duration of this patient pregnancy will be less than 260? In other words, what's the probability of X bar to be less than 260? So assume this is the X bar, the distribution of X bar. So assume this is 260. So we're looking for this area. So we're gonna use, we'll be using normal CDF. So this is gonna be normal CDF. So we go in a calculator, you need to go as far as, I'm just gonna use negative 1000 because that's much smaller than for standard deviation. You can use any really, really small number. So it goes from negative 1000 as the lower bound to 260 as the upper bound. Now remember, the mean of all the means is 266, and the standard deviation is 2.07. And if you use your calculator, it's supposed to get 0.18%. In other words, 0.0018. And that's it for this problem.